Okay, welcome back guys to Gamdo YouTube channel. Okay, so today we're going to try to fix some of the error that come from Standard Asset. As you know, Standard Asset is made by Unity, and then for almost like 2 or 3 years that the asset has not been updated by the Unity, and then some error may occur when we are try to run our game, right? So but actually the error is not something that block building the game, but it is only the warning like legacy or obsolete, something that obsolete, like perhaps like the function, the method that is not going to support in the future. So we will figure out how to fix that warning, and then so we going try to find the warning from the Unity editor console, and then after that we try to fix it by taking or reading the news, and then by reading the newest documentation of Unity of how to implement or to fix that warning. Okay, so I've been working with some of the standard asset that given me warning. For example, this is platformer. So if you use the standard asset and then you try to run your game, and then the Unity will give you a warning in the console. The warning is this is, I always use this one, right? So people, if you are programming and if you are a newbie in the programming, so make sure that you write everything, like everything that change inside your script, right? So I make kind of region, and then I put, and here this is Indonesian language, so you may not understand it, but I put like obsolete that like this one, this is build target. So in the future Unity will not support this one, not going to support it. And then so the editor building action build target change, they're not going to Unity in the future we're not going to use the active build target change. So in order to fix this, if you go like googling with you, like googling into like documentation of Unity or googling inside the Stack Overview, you will find the solution to this problem. So for the solution for this problem is I make the build target chain class. This is the class, public class, and this is inherited from the I active build target change. So because I active build target change has been not going to be exist in the future, Unity change it with the I active build target change. So I make the class public callback order, which is only get and return, and then on active build target change with the parameter of your first target and the next target, right? So this is the solution for the changing the active build target change. So instead of using this one, which is the warning for obsolete function, I'm using this one. Okay, so I just comment it out, but I'm not delete it, because in the future perhaps I need it if my class, or this is my method, not working properly. So I can still have tracking the old script, that all the old function. Okay, so that's the first. This is also the same with the void onable, and this is the void disable. This is actually the same. Okay, so this is the first, and then go to a other script is cross platform input initialize. Okay, so for this problem, let me see that what is the problem here. Oh, I see. Okay, this is the problem with the build target. So because PSM and Tizen, Unity has, I mean, like almost like since 2000. If I'm not mistaken, it's been like 5 years, I think, Unity not support PSM and Tizen. So I will just comment it out. This is quite simple. Just comment it out, and then it's the warning will disappear. Like this also similar, like cast building target PSM and Tizen, commenting out, and then the warning is go away. Okay, so it's quite simple. And then particle system destroyer. Okay, this is the particle system is quite tricky, because the legacy particle system use many of float inside the class, and then inside the struct. Okay, but in today particle system, Unity use like curve instead of float. They use curve, like they use like this one. They use emission module. So particle system, they use other constructor or other class to build the particle system. So inside the particle system, they have like main module, which is the module of particle, where the developer or programmer like us can change the particle inside the inspector. Instead of using the script, we can change the value of the particle system inside the inspector. They come with the nice UI, so we have to read carefully about the documentation of the newest particle system. So because the particle system is has been changed by Unity, for example, I will just show you that this is the default, I mean that legacy used in the script system.enable emission. So because the enable emission is boolean, and then we can use like equal to false. But in the newest particle system, we need and we have to use the emission module. So because emission module is, for example, this is emission module is the struct, right? So we cannot use struct change it into a boolean. Okay, so the solution is try make the particle system emission module as a variable, and then make it like system emission, and then emit module, and then we can, because we store the particle system emission module into the variable, means that we can change the emit module enable, and then is it false. So that's how we change the system dot enable emission equal to false. So that's solved. Okay, so if you have any question about particle system, don't forget to try first reading the documentation of the reason, I mean like the newest particle system in Unity. Or if you have a question, just comment below, guys. Okay, next we going to tone mapping. Okay, this is also is quite simple, but tricky again. Okay? So be careful, and then try to read the documentation of the Unity, I mean the newest documentation of Unity, because sRGBT texture, this is default as code importer line texture true. So because the line texture is the legacy, and then they're not supported anymore. I mean, like in the future, they're not supported anymore. So we change it to sRGB text. If you read the Unity documentation, the RGB 24 is something that compress. So texture in Unity has two type of texture. One is compressed and one is uncompressed. So you better read it first before you change your script. Okay. So this is the solution for the line texture and the texture format for RGB 24. Okay, so we going next to the other script. Okay, now this one. Okay, support render texture and support image effect are obsolete. Okay, so in the future, like we don't need to like checking whether the render texture and image effect is supported inside the Unity, because by default Unity has been like built in support the render texture and support the image effect, so you don't have to put it or instantiate it into your script. By default, Unity has the ability, like not the ability, like this is default, this is already support render texture and support image effects. So just comment it out and then put it. Don't delete it, just comment it out. Perhaps in the future you need it. Okay. You need it because perhaps you have another or other old project that you going to update it, and then you can check your this script as a like tracking perhaps, like okay. So this is quite simple. Next to another script, blur script. So this is also similar with the other one. This is also the support render texture and support image effect. Just comment it out, and then the warning is disappear. Okay, it's simple. And then image effect is also, I think this is similar because where is, okay, yeah, this is simple. And then after that, motion blur. Okay, motion blur, where is my comment? Okay, motion blur is also similar. This is support render texture and support image effect, I mean. So just comment it out, guys. Okay, wait. Okay. Si goblok guys lagi main motor guys. Okay. Next is mobile control. Okay, mobile control. Where is the, what is the problem with this? Okay. Mobile control, I think this is also about the support target build target chain class, yeah. So this is similar with the first one. I mean, like the previous class, we need to make a class of build target chain class inherited from the iActive build target chains, and then we have the callback getter, and then connected build target chains, build target previous target, and then with the parameter of new target. Again, and then we debug it, and then yeah, this is the class that we're going to use to give the ability of changing build target. Okay, and then we comment out this one because this is in the future we're not be supported anymore by Unity. So that's quite simple, because that also we have also, I mean, like I have elaborated before. So this is noise and script. Where is the wait, I have to figure out. Okay, this is also about the support render texture. You just need to comment it out, like for example, this is I made a region, and then I put it inside the region. So just comment it out like this one, and then you can fold it into like into one line. Other script is image effect. I think this is also similar. This is the support for render texture, I think. Yes, this is support for render texture. This is similar with the other, with the previous one. And then screen space obsolete, and then system support. Okay, this is checking whether is it not support, but by default Unity support the render texture and image effect. Okay, just comment it out, put it inside the region, and then comment it out. Okay, the other one is water. So what is the problem with water? Okay, this is also similar with the previous one. Yeah, so render texture is automatically cold. So by default render texture and image effect is already supported by Unity. You don't have to to make sure that it's supported. Okay, active trigger. Okay, how about active trigger? Okay, this is the old one, destroy object target game object. So because destroy object has is the legacy legacy method or legacy function that in the future that Unity not going to support it anymore, then we just use the newest one. This is destroy target game object. It's quite simple, it's quite handy. It the name is straightforward, right? Just destroy, not destroy object like this one. Okay, that's quite straightforward. Like force reset. Okay, this is quite tricky. Not because this is hard, but because for example, if you use this one only, this one, like scene manager get active inside, for example, I think like scene manager get active scene, it will not reset all your active scene. Not all, I mean like not all of your scene will be reset by this method. So in order to make it properly reset all the scene, you need to make like this scene manager dot load scene scene, and then scene manager get active scene by name. Okay, so this is the old one, the application before the Unity has the scene management. We use application load level, yeah. But today, like Unity use the scene management in order to manage the scene between scene inside your game. So make sure you read it, okay. And then after that, time object destroy. Okay, this is also like similar to the previous one. Destroy object is not supported anymore in the future, so we use destroy and then put it the parameter of game object. That's all. Okay, I think that's all that the warning that come from the standard asset, and make sure that you read the documentation before you make change to your script, because it might determine your game. I mean, like, it has to like determine your game, and then it has to affect your game and the system of your game, or whether is it physics or whether is it the shader. So make sure you read the documentation first, and then read carefully the script, and then read carefully what is the goals of the script, and then compare it to the news documentation that inside the Unity. So thank you for watching, guys. Next I'm going also to make a kind of similar a video like this one, but if you have like perhaps something old project that you're going to update it into the newest Unity feature, and then don't forget to comment, and then perhaps I'm going to make the video about that too. Okay, so thank you for watching. Don't forget to hit the thumbs up, like, comment, subscribe, and then see you on the next video, guys. Thank you for watching. Bye.